Hi, and welcome back to the e-telecast, God Has a Word for You. Now I'm Pastor Aminata. Well, we're wrapping up our little mini-series of Not So, looking at a few of the sayings that we've heard over and over again that some people, not all, some people have said were in the Bible, and come to find out it's not. And I hope that just by highlighting some of these things, you understand the significance of getting in that word for yourself. Come on now. We take the time to do everything else, but when it comes down, this is our nourishment. This is our spiritual food. And some of us are bulimic, spiritually bulimic. Either we're eating it, or we're not eating it, or we're eating it and we're throwing it up. Ooh, I think that's a topic of discussion for another time. Anyway, let me just share one more with you. All right? How about this? God helps those who help themselves. You heard that one? God helps those who help themselves. The Lord helps those who help themselves. That which means, okay, I'll help me. This way God will help me. But if I'm not helping me, then God won't help me? What does that mean? Well, let's look what the Bible says in Romans 5, verses 6 and 8. For while we were still helpless, doesn't sound like somebody's helping themselves, but while we're still helpless, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. But God demonstrated his own love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Let's not get it twisted, okay? Proverbs 28:26, he who trusts in his own heart is a fool. There's a whole lot of them out here today. But he who walks wisely will be delivered. And then in Jeremiah 17:5, thus saith the Lord, cursed is the man who trusts in mankind and makes flesh his strength and whose heart turns away from the Lord. See, we can get so puffed up, I got it, I can handle this, I can do this, I don't need God. Ooh, I'm scared of you. Listen, I've enjoyed myself. This has been a lot of fun. Keep sending us the emails. We really appreciate it. And I encourage you to help us evangelize through the internet. We send everything else out. All those chain letters that go out. Ooh, if you send somebody, send 10 people this letter and you will get blessed mightily by God in 10 seconds or whatever. Stop that. This is the word. Until the next time, I'm Pastor Aminata. God has a word for you. God bless.
Yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says that if I confess with my mouth, Lord Jesus, and believe in my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now, I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and that I need God in my life. So I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. Amen. So if you prayed that prayer, I want you to drop us a line and email us. And let us know, because right now, you are saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and find yourself a Bible-believing church and continue to grow in grace. God bless you.